Today's discussion topic. First, I'm going to talk about aim and objective. Then my friend Sharon, she will talk about the background, digital marketing versus traditional marketing, as well as she will talk about some data. Also, I will talk about some theory. And finally, based on our findings, then Smith will talk about evaluation, challenges, and finally, recommendation. Let's see our aim and objective. The aim of this research to explore the implementation of digital and social media marketing in business education marketing curriculum in Scotland. In order to achieve this aim, we try to find out how the Scottish business is using it, digital and social media marketing. And we try to investigate the impact of digital and social media marketing in Scottish business education. Then we find out the challenges of implementing social media marketing in Scottish business education curriculum. And finally, we are trying to provide some recommendation in order to implement digital and social media marketing in business education curriculum in Scotland. Now I'm going to hand over to my friend Sharon. She will talk about the background and some data.
Thank you, Nazmul. Now I'm going to discuss about the difference between traditional marketing and digital marketing. We have found a picture of the survey taken in 2013 between traditional marketing, which refers to typically advertising through non-social media contents like newspaper, magazines, etc., versus digital marketing, which the advertisings are made through social networks. As we can see in 2013, since people started using digital marketing, with 73% of social network sites and like more than 55% of blogs and mobile media are being used. Whereas in traditional marketing, there is a decrease in the use of newspaper, television, radio and other things. So it is said that the traditional marketing, it is being reached only to local people and is expensive. It's difficult to find the number of people using it, has low return on investment when compared to digital. And the most negative is that with traditional marketing, it is difficult to interact with the audience. In digital marketing, it is being reached globally, where it is cost efficient, it is measurable, in which we can check how many people are using. Also, we can find from which country they are looking at and many more useful things. It is not only being used in PCs and laptops, but also being used by mobiles and smartphones. Next, we have the Global Digital Snapshot, a survey taken on January 2015 of individual account users, that the total population in the globe, including children, is about 7.2 billion internet users with fixed and mobile connections for 3 billion, 2.78 billion of social media active accounts, 3.6 billion of unique mobile phone users and active mobile social media accounts of 1.6 billion. So it shows like more than half of global people are being digitalized. As we are focusing on the impact of Scotland curriculum, here we have the percentage of only adults using the internet for their personal use. Like in every year, it has been increased. From 2007, 60% to 2014, it has reached up to 82% of internet users. Here, we have done a research on Scotland's current situation on internet non-users, a survey calculated from January to March 2014, in which it clearly shows in Scotland only 12.8% and nearly 87.2% of people are using internet. As the first part of the question is about digital and social media marketing in business, we have done an overview of Scottish business, in which the survey done by Scottish Export in 2013 says only 10% of Scottish business companies have a clear vision and goal in processing to the digital strategy. Press and Buzz in December 2014 found that 40% of small and medium sized enterprise companies doesn't have or use any websites of their own, with 71% of them had websites, they were not capable or known to handle online queries from the customers. But in 2015, the same Scottish Expo took a survey in which nearly 58% of Scottish business companies have started using digital and social media sites. Overview of current Scotland educational background in which Though Scotland includes computing in its activities, the computer science importance is not given in the school. Likewise, Scotland includes marketing in its curriculum, as here they use both traditional and digital in their business. Some universities started using social and digital technology for sending the university's reports and module details to students through social media, and many more useful things can be used in education. The course of study in schools, colleges and universities in Scotland started using the digitalization and social media so that it helps people to be successful in learning, be confident in their own individual way, a responsible citizen and be efficient in their contribution. As we can see, the digital marketing course is in Scotland. Only two universities, Robert Gordon and West of Scotland, have specialized course of MSc digital marketing, whereas other universities doesn't have and specializes in other courses like business management, media and marketing. Moving on to the theoretical part, my friend Nazmul will take up the voice.
Thank you, Sharon. Now I am going to talk about why digital marketing is necessary in traditional marketing. According to Dahlstrom and Edelman, the new world of on-demand digital marketing has created into four major areas. First one is now. Consumer wants to connect anytime, anywhere by using social media. Therefore, digital marketers need to understand the importance of interaction of product globally. The second one is can I. To do so, this is the first 21st century. People are more into technologies and they are desperate to try new things. For example, newspaper reader can usually download newspaper application into their device, which save their time and money. Therefore, it's clear that digital marketers needed in marketing education. Another example of UWS module. You can see students have access to module 24/7 where they can access to their required document. Third one is forming. From the technology, business can profile their customer and send the offer accordingly. For example, email marketing, Facebook PPC can be done, their consumers likes and interest. And last one is simple, it's very simple because it's easy to get interaction and marketers send the information easily. In this slide, a student lives online, increasingly mobile and social-wise. This is the research being done in US. 6 to 12 classes, 63% of the student wants their textbook to be online. One third of the student in middle and high school student wants their textbook to be online, as well as their teachers should contact with them through social media. This research has done in US, as I have mentioned. So there is so much things which is in favor to digital marketing. Now I'm talking about the digital marketing framework. According to Pearson, 1998 believed that to achieve success in digital marketers should create a new model with five essential elements, which was old, but digital marketers still using it. which are attract, engage, retain, learn, and relay. Attract. Attract customer to the product. Everyone, including traditional marketing, is doing it, such as advertising. Engage. Generate interest to the community in social media is the best way to engage customer. For example, Facebook and Twitter have the largest online community. Retain. Company now have their company profile online and they keep their customer by sending message and interaction. So digital marketers should know how to keep themselves online. Learn. Learning is about customer preference, which is comment, share, retweet. For traditional marketers need to learn this in order to keep themselves into the business. Relate. Customize and interaction value delivery. So we can see that from this model, traditional marketers need to learn digital marketing in order to keep themselves into market. Now I am going to talk about how this digitalization can be implemented. Shostak model is one of the best model to practice. First, situation analysis. Where we know where we are now, doing SWOT analysis, we can find that. Then the second one is objective. 5 years objective or SMART objectives can be done here. Most of the marketers using SMART objectives, which are specific, measurable, attainable or achievable, relevant and time-based. Then the strategy. We know they should have the right strategy in place. Then the tactics. They should know how exactly they can be there. Then finally, action. Based on the tactics, they need to create their action and to control and evaluate. Every time, whatever they do, they should control and evaluate. Now I am going to hand over to my colleague Smriti. She will talk about the challenges for the educators.
Thanks, Nath. Going forward, I'm just going to discuss about the challenges for educators. There is no doubt that technology has transformed the way business use marketing and the way marketers use technology, but still education institution is facing some difficulties to implement it. Students of marketing would need to learn traditional marketing skills while also creating a new mental model with regard to the co-evaluation of consumers and business in a socially meditated world. This is an era of technology. Current student has born in digitalized world, but I'm sorry.